So you've given me four extemp speeches, and that's fantastic. Now let's really dive in and figure out how extemp works. Here's the thing. I'm a little crunched for time as I make these videos over Christmas break to be ready for second semester. So what that means is I'm going to cut to some older videos that I did when I was trying to be an influencer and, you know, I was trying to be down with the kids. They're incredibly cringe and I'm ashamed of them, but I'm going to cut back and forth between them. So just ignore the cringy aspect of them and get the information out of them. I'm going to go over the rules. I'm going to go over how the extemp draw works and how you structure a speech. All right, there you go. Then after that, you're going to do another give me a hand speech. Before I cut to the first video, let me just remind you, extemp is about current events. We have two kinds, foreign or international extemp, which is world issues, and we have domestic or U.S. extemp, which is U.S. issues, United States issues. So you can choose between those. One's no harder than the other. They're both the same. Not as many people do foreign extemp, so if you're looking for maybe an easier shot to regionals and state, that might be it. But I don't care at this point which one you choose, whichever one you're more comfortable with at this point, and then I'll probably make you choose later, or I'll choose for you. So there's that. That's extemp. Now watch these videos, learn a little bit more about it, and then come back. In Oklahoma speech and debate, the maximum time limit for extemporaneous speaking is 7 minutes, but you want to plan on going 6 to do well. Now, in a National Speech and Debate Association contest, the maximum time limit is 6, so that changes things a little bit, and we do go to both kinds of contests, but it's not really a problem.
Here's how it works. You draw 5 current event questions.
Are there 5 fingers there? Oh, there. There.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 3, 5, 3, 1. 1, 4, 6.
And then you have 30 minutes to prepare your speech using your extemp files.
What the heck are extemp files?
We'll get to it. Here's a cool thing. You do get to use a note card, but the note card can only have 50 words. And
here's the kicker.
Symbols and numbers count for words, so you want to use them sparingly.
In fact, you want to ditch using the note card as soon as possible.
It's open to grades 9 through 12, so everybody does it. And guess what? On our team,
everybody does it.
At least for a little while.
It's so humid.
Now, some of you may be wondering, wait a second, we draw questions?
How the heck does that work?
Well, there's a magical place.
Magical?
Called the extemp draw. For more on that, let's turn to the Super Friends.
Dedicated to truth, justice, and peace for all mankind.
The Super Friends await their fate in the extemp draw, presided over by the Joker. He has the questions and calls roll.
Aquaman, Flash, has anybody seen that?
I'm right here.
Superman,
Batman. Boy Wonder.
Looks like the first speaker is you, Bats.
Move back, Joker, while I draw 5 questions. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is the one. There must be something in the bat files.
First speaker has 10 minutes.
Concentrate. Concentrate.
First speaker is dismissed to their room.
I'm out of here.
Are you my Joker?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, probably. What's your name?
I'm Batman.
Yeah, it's you. Come on in.
For all mankind!
So the extemp draw isn't scary. And remember, there's always a coach in the extemp draw who will be happy to answer your questions. Well, maybe not happy to answer your questions, but they'll do it. What do we know so far? We know that extemporaneous speaking is all about current events, that you draw 5 questions, you pick one, you have 30 minutes to prepare a speech using your extemp files, and then at the end of that 30 minutes, you are sent to your round where you deliver your speech. What's your next question?
How do you write an extemp speech?
That's a great question. And the first answer is, well, you don't really write it. You just do an outline.
An outline? What? All I got's an outline? You're blowing my mind.
Yeah, don't worry. You can do it. As long as you understand the structure of your extemp speech, you'll do fine.
Hey, great treehouse. I built it in 2 days, and I didn't even follow any plans. Why waste time?
Hold on!
Whoa!
Gotcha!
Quick kick! I guess I was in too big of a hurry.
Remember, anything worth doing is worth planning. If you don't plan,
you're out on a limb. Now I know.
And knowing is half the battle.
G.I. Joe!
Thanks, Quick Kick! One of the G.I. Joe characters based not at all on racist, stereotypical tropes. Let's put on our hard hats, kids. Because we're about to build some stuff. You remember this structure from like the first lesson of Lincoln-Douglas debate. It's basically the same thing. You have a thesis statement supported by your contentions. In this case, we usually call them areas of analysis, but it's the same thing. Let's take a look. The thing you're gonna start with is your introduction and the question. So you'll tell a story or a joke or use a quote maybe, and then tie that into your question. You state the question, followed by an answer. After you answer the question, you wanna signpost your speech. That means you're going to tell the judge what your 3 or 2 or 77 points are.
So, judge, I am going to say yes, and I'm going to support it with 3 areas of analysis.
That's a preview of your speech. So, introduction, ask the question, answer the question, then say,
I'll support this answer.
Well, not like that. I'll support this answer with 3 areas of analysis. First, second, and third. And then you move into your speech. The next Lego block in our build, the first area of analysis. Let's take the question Batman selected. Should President Lex Luthor be impeached? For the record, in the comic, Lex Luthor has been at times the President of the United States. This is in no way a commentary on our current political, you know, crisis. So let's say Batman said no. He'd need 3 areas of analysis. Batman's first Lego block might be something like the Justice League will take care of him before they need to impeach him. The next part of the speech is the second area of analysis. For Batman's speech, that might be something like he definitely should be removed from office because Lex Luthor, as we all know, is corrupt. Again, I'm speaking only of Lex Luthor when he served as president in the comics. I am not at all, in no way, there's no connection to our current situation.
There might be.
And finally, your third area of analysis. For Batman, it might just be something simple like,
I'm Batman.
The final block in our incredible speech structure is the recap and conclusion. Remember how you did the signposting and you told us what you were going to tell us? After you go through each of those areas of analysis, you basically just review them and you say, so, here was my question. I answered it this way. I supported it with these 3 areas of analysis. And now I'm going to conclude my speech. The conclusion creates a sense of closure so that they know it's over and that they can clap. Okay, now, you're gonna give me another give me a hand speech. This will be speech number 5, I think. It can be 2 minutes, so no less than 2 minutes, but you don't have to go over 2 minutes. I don't care what the topic is, as long as you have the structure and that you actually write the outline. So introduction, point 1, point 2, point 3, and conclusion. Remember, at the end of the introduction, you signpost what you're going to tell us in the 3 sections. Make sure you video it. 1, 2, 3, go.